guys a wonderful day. Hello, everybody. It's Amanda Webb here, and I wanted to jump on here and do a podcast. I want to wish everybody hello. It's been a while since I've been on. I wanted to tell everybody about, firstly, this important project of mine. It is called Meeting Faith. You can email me at amandawebbmusic@gmail.com. Basically, you will tell an epic tale doing a self-tape, 15 minutes max, and I will post it to my YouTube, and you will tell people about how real God is in your life, how he's helped you, how you overcame struggles. We need more positivity in the world, and if you have a story that you would like to tell, please contact me, or even find me on Facebook, Amanda Webb. I'm a music singer, songwriter, beat mixer, producer. I wear many different hats in this industry, even broadcaster. So I will put my link up here, and I'll also show you my YouTube for you to also get an idea of what I'm talking about. If you have more than 15 minutes, we can do like two different segments, like two different 15-minute segments, or even three, however long you have, so your story of how God helped you can be heard. Which brings me to my next topic today. We all struggle immensely. We wonder sometimes, how am I going to get to point A to point B in life? Sometimes we have thrown so many detours, and we wonder why. Why is this happening? Why? Well, sometimes in our faith, we may believe that God can do something, but we doubt. Sometimes we think we're not doubting, but we are. Or God wants to help us out so much, and we believe so much in him, but we sometimes want to help him when, on some occasions, God don't need our help. He just needs us to be still and sit and wait and let him do it all. Sometimes when we try to intermingle with what God has planned for us and try to help him and think he needs our help and touch the thing that he's trying to work on, we as humans fail. And sometimes we mess our blessings up. Sometimes we have to work for our blessings. It doesn't just fall in our lap. Money doesn't just grow on trees. We have to sometimes work for it. We can't always win the lottery. Sometimes we're not given the best cards dealt in life. But as long as you have faith that something good can still come of it, as long as you put in the work and just know that God can handle anything that you throw at him, and let him and his handiwork take care of it, and let his hands take care of it, versus us trying to get in the mix of what he's trying to do with his own hands, then and only then can you truly have faith. And those mountains in your way will be moved. Sometimes we overthink the things of what God can or can't do. Sometimes we don't give him enough credit for what he has done. Sometimes we don't give him the thanks and the praise and the glory of everything that he has done. Sometimes the I or the me takes hold in place of what he has done. We sometimes try to take credit for God's credit. And that's another blessing blocker. So, be thankful, believe, and trust that he can handle anything. 2 Peter 5:10 or 1:10. I probably got this a little bit confused. Please don't strike me dead or criticize me for it. But one of those scriptures in Peter says, cast all your care upon him, for he cares for you. He cares for you so much that he sent his own son to die on the cross for your sins and for you to have a life, and a life more abundant. In John 8:14, no greater love than this, than a man to lay down his life for his friends. We are his friends. He laid down his life for us, so we also ought to lay down our lives for him and for others. But knowing that without him, we can't do that. Too many times we sit around the table, we think, oh, I did this, I made that paycheck. That's not our money, in all truth. God was the one that supplied, he's the one that provided for you to have that money, to have around the table, and to have a nice meal. Sometimes there are people that go without, and it's not because that they made poor choices. Sometimes it's not because that there's something wrong with them. Everybody's equal in God's eyes. You just sometimes judge or think that person is less than us, when that's not the truth. The truth of the matter is that God loves everybody, and so should he. That person that may be not on their feet, maybe God has them where they need to be in order for them to see him. Maybe that person could be more Christian than you. You think, well, I go to church, I read the Bible on Sunday, Wednesday, I have my quiet time with God. That doesn't make you Christian. What makes you Christian is being like Christ. And being like Christ means going the extra mile and walking in their shoes. The one that you think, oh man, I feel bad for that person, I can't believe it. You know, the one that you judge every second. Training your mind and realizing that they're God's children too. That they need your help. Maybe praying for them. Maybe giving them money. Whatever you do, do all in the glory of God. Yourself, because everything that you have done or worked hard for can be all taken away just like that. So I hope as you go to bed tonight, if you have a bed to sleep on, remember that God loves you too, and that there is another person out there just like you, or who may not have as much as you, to pray for them as well. Eventually, you'll meet them too. They'll be standing right beside you at the same gate you'll be standing beside. As what you did with God in your relationship, that's between you and him. There's going to be an account for everything one day. And that day's coming sooner than what it looks like. You can see everything around this world today and know that, you know, Jesus is coming back. He's coming back for who he's sooner. Each day is a new day sooner than the next of each day that he's coming. I don't know about you, but I don't want to be that kid that's ashamed to see Jesus. I want to be at his feet and have him say, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant. Here is your reward." And then lay back those rewards back at his feet. Because none of us are perfect. But yet he sent his perfect son to die on the cross for our sins. Amazing love. How can it be that he would die for you and me? So tonight, if you wonder how to experience that love, and you want your life to be totally changed, and you believe in your heart that he is who he says he is, that you would like to receive forgiveness for anything that you have done in your life, it doesn't matter what you've done, he would like to take you in. He stands at the door and knocks, but he don't push his way in. Just say, "Father God, I'm sorry for what I've done. I know I've done a lot of wrong in your eyes. I know I've done a lot of many mistakes. God, but here I am. And here you are. I ask that you come into my heart and that you change me and mold me and let me receive your Son and your Holy Spirit. He will come in and he will change everything about it." Change happens just like that sometimes with him, but it still takes a process and learning about him and reading about him and seeing people how he sees people. If you pray that prayer, ask him to come in, and you believe in your heart that he is who he says he is, and you confess it out of your mouth that he raised up from the dead, you will be saved. You'll be saved from a lot of things. It's not the most easiest route or the most popular route that people take. But if you truly ask for forgiveness and you turn away from everything that you have done wrong and try live the best that you can live for him, I promise you the rewards are much better at the end. You may not get that mansion here on earth, but his mansion that he's building up top on you when you die is going to be far greater than any mansion that you can have and buy on this earth with money. His love is going to be far greater than you and I will ever know from anyone that's human. Imagine the sun as bright as it is outside, wherever you're at when the sun comes up. Up in heaven, it's going to be 10 times brighter. There will be no need for sun because his spirit and his light will shine everywhere brighter than this sun here on earth. I promise you, you will not want to miss heaven. Time is short. We're never promised tomorrow. So if you're feeling God to call you tonight, please just pray that prayer and just be open and honest with him. Just like I'm talking to you guys, talk to him the way you would talk to your mother, your daughter, your son, your sister, your brother, your nephew, a normal conversation. Just between you and him. Even if you don't feel like closing your eyes and bowing your head and praying, he still knows your heart. He made you. And he can hear you. No matter where you are, he can touch you. Let him heal you. Let him heal you by his spirit, by his blood, by his power. And let let him give you the life more abundant that you deserve. And I hope that you guys have made the right decision to walk by faith. That was sung by Jeremy Camp. The song goes, credit goes to him. And give all praise and glory to God. It's a sure thing you will die. It's a sure thing there will be either heaven or hell. Choose life, choose heaven. It's not going to be the easiest route. I promise, but at least he will never leave you or never forsake you. He will always be by your side, up there and down here on earth.